I'm 16. A blogger, I write the blog Leveon Ross, and I was asked to come here to interview the Taoiseach and to write about this conference about youth enterprise as a young person myself. Would you like to
sit? This is action photography.
What are your top three priorities for the development of youth entrepreneurship in Ireland?
I think it's important to stimulate interest, show them examples of how people can get on ahead, and to provide the opportunity for better.
And what do you see as the main challenges to enterprise education in Ireland?
I think it's a lack of clarity and leadership to show young people that they're going to be the carriers of the big responsibility of driving the country. We've got to give them the opportunity to do that. So it's to expose them to the challenge and let them use the potential to rise to that challenge.
And creativity is a big part of enterprise. How do you think creativity could be better encouraged in Irish classrooms?
I think it's by example of how other young people around the world have made major breakthroughs in a whole range of sectors, but also to stimulate the particular interest and flair and the creativity and imagination that young people have. And you only get that when you get them together and feel the energy coming off them, but you give them challenges and opportunities to let that happen. All done?
Good stuff, thanks so much.
Thanks, mate.
Thank you very much.
Great, not at all, delighted.
And when I speak to young people who've just been in Sydney or Vancouver or Seattle or wherever, and your head will be bursting with ideas because they see that, they've got that energy and they see the potential. But they need the little strings to help them, lead them through to a point where they can all take off. And that's what you're doing. That's what you're doing here. So even within the constraints of the IMF-EU deal, which are constraints on our country, in the next month, we're going to introduce a series of initiatives to attempt to provide some stimulus for those within our own economy who will generate confidence and a sense of hope and a sense of encouragement to spend money, to invest money, to want to take back employees. And coming as I do from the west of Ireland, the same region as Enda Cunin, I know just how endemic the business of emigration has always been. And yet because we are an island nation, that sort of competitive instinct is very much alive in our people. And when you're asked to stand up against the challenges of other peers from around the world, Irish people have always been able to do that in full measure, be it in culture or in literature or in the arts or in sport or in engineering or in productivity. And that's why our country in many ways has all of the ingredients to put us right back up there at the top.
And there was a wee tiny AI tournament, he was letting them in the process of turning around the end.
700.
Wow.
So, are they selling well, are they?
Yeah.
Are you selling the chops around the boat?
Well, it all started while we were in Hull Days in Antrim. We were at a craft fair and there was a man there making the pens. And he allowed members of the public to turn their own pens. And we got our idea from there. We were bragging, Mum and Dad, can we get a lathe? Can we get a lathe? So they finally gave in and got us a small lathe. And then we started from there.
Well, this pen here, this pen's bog open. This came out of a bog up in Edinburgh.
School for a logo competition to raise awareness about what we were doing this year, and that was the winning one, so we were
going to
get
the bags. We're
going to be selling them in our school.
I'm Aisling Baldry,
and I'm Emma O'Leary, and we're here with our eco-friendly bags.
We came up with the idea for eco-friendly bags because we found as a group that we were very passionate about climate change and the impact of non-renewable bags on the environment. So we came up with the idea of using reusable bags and selling them in our school. So we ran a competition in our school.
A logo competition, and we had a winning logo which you've now put on the bag. All the proceeds of the bags go to Trokra, because we've done it in conjunction with Trokra, because we found that loads of people across the world are affected by climate change every day, and we wanted to help these people with our project.
How are you?
Good, thank you. How are you?
Hello,
hi, nice to meet you.
Good. So what are you doing?
Basically, we did an app for smartphones that calculates the carbon footprint.
Yeah. Yeah. I saw this at the Young Scientist.
Yeah. Exactly, yeah. I don't think you'd remember.
I did. Yeah. Yeah. It was really for, it's a free app, isn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, I remember that. I was trying to think about the business.
You can take a card here if you want.
It worked out your carbon
footprint. Yeah.
Hi, I'm Kate O'Regan,
Kira Walsh,
and Ruth Dargan.
And we're from Loretto, St. Stephen's Green.
We made an app for iPhones which calculates your carbon footprint. And it can be downloaded from the carbonfootprintcalculator.com.
And basically, you put in the amount of minutes you spent using different household appliances, and then you get back two things. You get back your exact carbon footprint, your exact carbon emissions, and then it's also displayed graphically in comparison to the average teenager and user in Ireland.
And then we also have tips on why you're juice and everything, just in the app as well.
So basically this is our app here. There's kind of five sections. There's the why reduce section, which tells you like what climate change is and how important it is to actually reduce your carbon footprint. There's the tips section, which have kind of simple but really effective tips on how to actually reduce that carbon footprint. And then the main section is the calculate section. So you input their household appliances. So you input the amount of minutes you spent using different household appliances, and then you get your actual result, and it's displayed graphically in comparison to the average and says whether you're good, bad or average.
I'm actually in college now, in Vancouver College. For education.
Yeah.
I make a lot of things from recycled materials,
yeah.
Such as this particular piece here is made from a CD.
From a CD?
Yeah, so it's caught file down, so of course it's appropriate for children as well, because there's no kind of scratches around.
And the chain?
The chain I make myself, I get a big loop chain, like cut it up. So everything is from scratch. So the jewellery here, these are only, ones here are only €5, which is very affordable for people, of course. And as well, that 50% goes to charity.
So how long does it take to make something like this?
It doesn't take too long. To be honest, what I do is I make a bunch together.
Yeah.
So I do bits and pieces and kind of do it measure because I enjoy doing it. Yeah, I have tools and stuff like that. Yeah,
where did you get that interest from?
I just always loved jewelry from my young age, and I just kind of had some CDs at home, and I said, you know what, I could do something with that.
No, that's yours.
Mine is handmade crafted cards. Pretty much I made 700 to date and sold 650 of them. And they're only €2. There's a few on you.
So when you see them, when you see them coming, you say, charges for like €2, €3, €1.
Well, no, it's just...
Have you laminated within for this, or what do you do?
No, that's just a cover, so as the product doesn't get damaged when it's being brought to the person.
And you chose Bill Haley for this one?
Yeah.
Rock around the clock, yeah.
Great. What's the... our product is a piece of wearable technology that's capable of locating firefighters and measuring their vital signs and electricity, and then take that information and transmit it wirelessly to a tablet PC in possession of commanding officer, and then using that information to coordinate search and rescue efforts and deploy troops more effectively.
This is Owen Markey, and along with my colleague Oisín O'Din, we are Team Prometheus. The product that we have is basically going to save lives. It is a wearable piece of technology which should go inside the lining of the jackets of emergency personnel. It's going to monitor their heart rates, and it's going to relay that and their position within a building or within any sort of the fire ground to a website, which can be monitored by their station officer or whoever's coordinating the human resources. It can be monitored on anything that can pick up internet, be it an iPhone, Android phone, tablet PC or a laptop.
Basically, it's a ready-mix protein drink, so it's relatively new to the Irish market. And it's supplement your diet basically for extra protein requirements, and it'll also be an energy range of drinks as well. So for those who need that boost to live that hectic lifestyle, and they will be also sugar-free.
So what's this now in comparison? You went to these filling stations, you see all this stuff there. Energy and
as regards, we say energy drinks currently on the market, they would be say loaded with sugar, where these would be zero sugar products, and we basically treat them in the caffeine, and we just basically supplement your diet and
I see
improve mental.
So, what sort of experimentation did you do with young people to drink these?
Sample blind tests, per se. So the feedback's been positive, and they're all 100% Irish manufactured as well.
Yeah.
So over the last couple of weeks and months, we developed the formulas with the help of the Irish manufacturers.
So what's the ingredient in this now here?
That's a protein drink, so it'll be 30 grams protein. It's whey protein isolate, so it'll be absorbed into the bloodstream fairly rapidly. Mm. And then the energy.
So if I'm doing the Ring of Kerry for charity this year, as I did last year, a few of these would be...
It'd be ideal to supplement your diet.
Has this been done anywhere else? I mean, what about the international people that the long wind up on as well?
There are some... but they operate manually, or else they require they require you to wind them up yourself. But some of them also use like the earphones are attached to the device itself, so you can't use your own earphones. Whereas this
you could
separate the case and put in your own earphones. You know. So.
I have a young man who said, that's cool now. That's cool. Sometimes in this business, it is well off not having earphones.
My name is Carol.
My name's Julie.
And my name's Katie.
And our product is Wind It Up. It's a small, innovative gadget designed to wind up earphones on mobile phones, iPods, MP3 players, and any other device that requires earphones. The purpose of the product is to prevent earphones become entangled and to reduce damage. So our objective is to increase the lifespan of earphones by providing an everyday solution to a common annoyance and therefore reduce the number of earphones that are disposed of.
It's using the same mechanism as a measuring tape, so if you pull out your earphones they will stop using a fall and ratchet mechanism, and then when you want to retract them back into the device, push the button and that's it.
Yeah, it's being a person with charges will be around it.
Yeah.